All right. Jack Gontos, Joey Pigza swallowed the key. Chapter 1, Off the Wall. At school, they say I'm wired bad, or wired mad, or wired sad, or wired glad, depending on my mood and what teacher has ended up with me. But there is no doubt about it, I'm wired. This year was no different. When I started out, all the days there looked about the same. In the morning, I'd be okay and follow along in class. But after lunch, when my meds had worn down, it was nothing but trouble for me. One day, we were doing math drills in class, and every time Mrs. Maxey asked a question like, "What's 9 times 9? I'd raise my hand because I'm really quick at math. But each time she called on me, even though I knew the answer, I'd just blurt out, "Can I get back to you on that?" Then I'd nearly fall out of my chair from laughing. And she'd give me that white-lipped look, which meant, "Settle down." But I didn't and kept raising my hand each time she asked a question until finally no other kid would raise their hand because they knew what was coming between me and Mrs. Maxey. "Okay, Joey," she'd say, calling on me and staring hard at my face as if her eyes were long fingers that could grip me by the chin. I'd stare right back and hesitate a second as if I was planning to answer the question, and then I'd holler out real loud, "Can I get back to you on that?" Finally, after a bunch of times of me doing that in a row, she jerked her thumb toward the door. "Out in the hall," she said, and the class cracked up. So I went and stood in the hall for about a second until I remembered the mini Super Ball in my pocket and started to bounce it off the lockers and ceiling. And after Mrs. Deebs in the next class stuck her head out the door and yelled, "Hey, cut the racket," like she was yelling at a stray cat, I remembered something I wanted to try. I had seen the Tasmanian devil on TV whirling around like a top, so I unbuckled my belt and pulled on the end real hard, as if I was trying to start a lawnmower. But that didn't get me spinning very fast. So I took out my high-top shoelaces and tied them together, and then to the belt, and wrapped it all around my waist. Then I grabbed one end and yanked on it and sort of got myself spinning. I kept doing it until I got better and better, and before long I was bouncing off the lockers because I was dizzy too. Then I gave myself one more really good pull on the belt, and because I was already dizzy, I got going really fast and began to snort and grunt like the Tasmanian devil until Mrs. Maxey came out and clamped her hands down on my shoulders. She stopped me so fast, I spun right out of my shoes, and they went shooting up the hall. "You glue your feet to the floor for 5 whole minutes, or you can just spin yourself down to the principal's office," she said. "Now, what is your choice going to be?" "Can I get back to you on that?" I asked. Her face turned all red. "5 minutes," she said. "Settle down for 5, and you can rejoin the class." I nodded. And when she was gone, I wrapped the belt and laces around my middle and gave it a good tug and began to spin and spin and slam into the lockers. And I got going so good, the gum I had under my tongue flew out, my Super Ball slipped out of my hand and went bouncing down the hall. And I kept going and going, like when you roll down a steep hill. And before long, I was bumping on the glass walls around the principal's office like a dizzy fish in a tank. And the principal came out and pinned me against the wall. We had a little talk about my behavior goals, and I spent the rest of the day on her office floor sorting out all the used crayons that the kindergartners kept in big plastic tubs until I had separate piles of blue and green and red and yellow, and you know the rest.